Hello everybody, it's Nantas Commander and welcome to episode 49 of Pokemon Battle Zone. In this episode I'm going to be showing off another new team that I've been working on, and I'm going to be leading off with my Whimsicott, and they're going to lead off with a Salamence, which of course is going to Mega Evolve right away, because let's be honest here, ever since Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire came out, literally every Salamence I've seen has Mega Evolved right away. So the whole strategy behind this Whimsicott is pretty much just to spam Prankster with its moves as much as possible before it dies. Unfortunately for this turn, it's not going to get that much action because Aerial Edge, Double Edge is going to want it KO me right away, because there's no way I can survive that thing. And I don't know what my hold item is. I think my hold item is actually leftovers. So that's probably why I didn't have the Focus Sash. So I bring in my Heatran now, which is cool because I'm actually Choice Scarfed with my Heatran, which is pretty much the go-to moveset for most Heatrans because it does have pretty decent speed. So combined with Choice Scarf, it is pretty good. So I'm going to KO that thing with Dragon Pulse. And now he brings in this Dusclops. I didn't know what it was going to do, so I thought, you know what, let's bring in my Pinsir. My Mega Pokemon for this team is actually Mega Pinsir, but... oh, I'm so sorry, Pinsir. I ruined it for you, didn't I, friend? I really should not have brought this thing in, because I should have predicted the Will-O-Wisp. And even though I'm going to Mega Evolve and do as much damage as I can, I'm pretty sure I'm not going to get much damage off with this Mega Pokemon now, because Burn kind of cripples me. And to make things even worse, I think I actually screwed up with the happiness scale for this Pokemon, because I think I forgot to maximize the happiness on this Pinsir, which means Return is only doing minimum damage, which combined that with the Burn is really bad. So unfortunately this pretty much means that I'm going to get hit by a Nightshade and I'm going to die to the Burn anyway. So sorry, Pinsir. I should have given you a much better debut than what you got. I'll try and make better use of you next time. So I bring in my Heatran now. I'm going to go ahead and use Fire Blast because I know Fire Blast will do a good chunk of damage. You know, possibly even a 2-hit KO or a 3-hit KO. But he goes for Will-O-Wisp. Now I understand my opponents might not be familiar with 4th gen Pokemon, but I'm genuinely surprised at that because Heatran has been around since Diamond and Pearl. So it does strike me as a surprise that he didn't know it carried Flash Fire. But then again, maybe this trainer is a newcomer to the Pokemon franchise and he has simply never played the 4th gen games, in which case I can't blame them at all. But he's now going to bring in his last Pokemon, which is Metagross, which of course is going to die to my Fire Blast and ultimately end the match. So here's my second Pokemon, and also on this team I actually carry a Terrakion, because Terrakion is just awesome. One of my favourite Pokemon from 5th gen. It's kind of funny because a lot of my favourite Pokemon are actually in 5th gen. So, yeah, you know, despite people hating 5th gen quite a bit apparently, it's actually one of my favourite generations if you want my honest opinion. So I'm going to get burned by another ghost type. Man, I'm getting burned by two ghost types in this video. Wow. So I'm going to go ahead and use Stone Edge. This really isn't going to do that much damage. Well, I've already used it once, but because of the burn, I'm still not going to be doing that much damage. And he carries the Recover. So, seeing the fact that this thing is not going to do that much damage against the Sableye, I might as well go ahead and bring in my Heatran. I was pretty confident he was going to go ahead and use Recover, so I thought I'd use the turn to bring my Heatran in. And oh my goodness! Do people not know about Heatran? First Flash Fire, now Steel type? Okay, I'm clearly... maybe Heatran is not as common as I think it is, but I've seen loads of Heatrans online. It blows my mind that there are people that don't know how to fight against Heatran, but whatever. I guess you can't judge everybody. There are some people that just flat out don't know things. I've been there myself, so I can't really blame them. So, they bring in Scrafty now. I recently fought one of those in a previous video. I'm going to go ahead and use Fire Blast to get rid of this thing. Oh, but it actually takes it. I actually forgot, Scrafty does actually have pretty decent special defense, so it doesn't come as a surprise that it's able to take a Fire Blast from my Heatran. Just a shame for it that I'm actually Choice Scarfed, and I'm still going to outspeed it anyway despite the Dragon Dance boost. The only thing I was fearing then was that Fire Blast was going to miss. So he brings in his last Pokemon, which is Aegislash, but I'm really not that bothered about this thing because it can King Shield all it wants. It really does not matter because next turn I'm just going to go ahead and use Fire Blast. And even with the Shield form, there's no way it's going to take a Fire Blast from a Heatran of that scale. So that comes to the end of this video. And as always, I will see you guys next time. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.